you bet. Do it for me.
I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road and gonna ride till I can't no more. I got the horses in the back.
Really then, I got the bag. Tell a friend, she got some ass. Bring it in, bitch. I'm the new CNN. Yeah.
Hi, loves. It's Robin Eve,
and it's your girl AT,
and we are back. We are doing our first video. It's a review because you know that's what we do. This is going to be a review on the show, The Masked Singer. Yes. So we are going to do a video every week. So make sure you tune in.
Notification button.
Yes, let us know what you think as the weeks go on, if we got it right, wrong, what your suggestions are, whatever the case may be. If you have not watched the episode on Wednesday,
which is
September, yes,
25th?
Yes.
I work third shift, y'all. I'm sorry.
September 25th. Please click off this video because there will be spoilers. For the person who was revealed at the end of the episode. So, if you do not know what the masked magician... Oh my God, I keep saying masked magician.
Me too. That's why when we started, I paused. Because I was like, masked magician, I had a... They say they just...
I keep saying together. It.
But
the Masked Singer.
Masked Singer.
If you don't know what it is, it's a show where there are celebrities of all walks of life. It can be singers, it can be actors, whatever. Come on a show. It's basically a singing competition. They're masked. They have different costumes on to hide their face. They have voice distortion.
Yes.
Except for their singing voice. So, basically, it's just you guessing who's under the mask. That's what's happening. It comes on Fox on Wednesdays.
So, this is season two.
Season two.
I didn't watch the first season. Robin Eve did. So, this is my first season with this show. I like it. It's very stressful.
It is.
It's very, it is. A lot of back and forth. This is self-doubt. Like, it's really good. So, this season started out with a butterfly, a egg, a thingamajig, skeleton, ladybug, which I love her costume, and the butterfly, rock wilder, a tree. They kept saying tree, but I want to say it's like a Christmas, Easter, it was a very festive tree. It was a really pretty tree.
Easter?
Because like the colors, like
it was a Christmas tree.
Well, like Christmas tree. I didn't say Christmas. And then we concluded with
an ice cream. So let's get into it. So for me, the butterfly. So some of the clues. I mean, I don't. It was like going through changes that they took a break over the last, you know, few months or year is what I got the impression of.
Yeah.
The Big Ben, which really threw me off, and I wrote "Take You to Church," and yeah. So the Big Ben, "Take You to Church." I kind of kept getting that it was an African American person. I kept getting that vibe. I don't know what that's about, y'all. I don't know. I just always kind of get a feel for what race they are. I don't know. It comes across sometimes. Sometimes it does.
We were like, having people walked out, like, oh, that's a black person.
Yeah.
It was like, you know.
Then they started, like, singing. You're like, oh, wait,
okay.
So, what did you think? What did you
have? So, my clues for the butterfly were transformation. In that past year, this person has recently gone through something major. Gospel singer, I wrote down for a clue. And then I also wrote for that transformation in something major was a bad breakup. So those were the clues that I wrote. I mean, those were what I wrote down from the clues that were given.
And so we did not discuss who we thought our picks were.
Yeah.
We waited. So for me, the first impression I got when he started singing was Michelle Williams from Destiny's Child. That's the impression I got. I got it when they first started singing, but then there were some notes in the song. I was like, ooh, I ain't heard Michelle hit them notes. So then it kind of threw me off a little bit. And then I did think Mel B. And I think after someone had suggested it, and I was like, oh my God, that makes sense. So I did also put down Mel B. So right now, I'm kind of back and forth between those two.
Okay, I only have one person, which I'm about 75% sure that this is the person. And I said Michelle Williams as well.
You did?
From Destiny Childs. Childs, from Destiny Child. Yes, her, she has a very, very distinct voice. And when she started singing, I was like, oh, girl, that's her. Because I've heard her, of course, you know, Destiny Child. But I also heard her gospel album. And she can't hit those notes that the Butterfly did hit. But her voice is so unique. And I think they kind of did try to distort her voice just a little bit. But her pitch, her normalcy came through.
And they, the judges did not guess her at all. So she's at least throwing them off. But I, immediately when she first started singing,
I was like, oh, God, that's Michelle.
She's and very, then it tied it to the Take It to Church.
Yeah. So you, as you, I don't know if y'all know, but she is, she came from a gospel background, was a gospel singer before going to Destiny's Child. And then afterwards, she went back. Within the last year, she had a bad breakup with that Chad guy.
So that's why I was like, okay.
So,
but the same thing for Mel B. She had a bad breakup. Well, see,
when you said Mel B, too, I was like, but Mel B, even though she's British, because that was a clue, one of the clues, was London. They had show like something in London. But, we're big fans of Spice Girls. So I literally, every Spice Girls song, I always know when Mel B's singing. In any song.
So
I didn't get Mel B.
So tell us what you guys thought and what you got there.
What you think?
The next one was The Egg. So I wrote Swan. Strong on the outside, but soft on the inside. On top of a pyramid, skateboard, always extra. So at first I had no absolute clue, but then I was thinking along the lines of just kind of extra out there, maybe correspondent, maybe someone who's used to speaking a lot for people. So I wrote Jonathan, which is the Kardashians' best friend. You might see him on the show sometimes.
He's with Kim a lot, yeah.
Yeah, he's with Kim a lot, but he's on the Keeping Up with the Kardashians.
Yeah.
So that's what my pick was.
So I wrote clues. Well, I just wrote the clues down from what they gave for the egg. So skateboard. They kept saying extra, so I was thinking, okay, correspondent. So I wrote down two people. For the skateboard reason, I wrote down Rob Durst. I don't know if I said his name, Rob. What did I say?
No, not what you say. We know who you're talking about. From Ridiculousness.
Yes. Big and Rob. And then my second choice was Mario Lopez. Only because the egg personality was very, what's that one word?
Flamboyant?
Well,
Metro?
Yeah. And I always thought Mario Lopez was very extra.
I don't know where she got that from. I did not know.
So I did put those two for my choice of the egg.
So, spoiler.
Boop,
so,
boop,
skip 10
boop.
Seconds. Do what you got to do.
Pop,
so,
oh,
the egg did not win. They got sent home. And it came out that the egg was Johnny Ware, which is a figure skater. So that was, so we were totally wrong on that one.
I would have never guessed that.
Never,
they
ever.
They could have put a picture of him up there.
I wouldn't have been able to say.
In his skates, and I'd be like, who's that?
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Would not have guessed that. He was a nice singer and really beautiful.
Yeah.
So the next thing, thingamajig. So I immediately got that. I thought it was a black guy. So bad. Oh, God. Y'all don't ring me for that. I wrote Gentle Giant, Magic. Because he was doing like a lot of magic stuff.
Yeah.
And then number four. And then basketball player. I'm sticking with thinking it's a basketball player. So I wrote Chris Webber. And I wrote Chris Bosh.
Okay.
All right. So I'm going with Chris Webber. But then I started to think he kind of seemed like he was more a little bit younger.
Yeah.
So then I was like, maybe it's Chris Bosh. So that's what I'm going with.
Okay. So for my thing, with Thingamajig, they did emphasize a lot on his big feet, playing basketball. And then he said that he can reach anything in small spaces. So I was like, okay, this got to be NBA player of some sort. So I did put down Dennis Rodman at first. And then it kept socializing with four. So I was like, is that four rings? Is that number four in the jersey? I did kind of do a little research. Couldn't find anything. So I'm like, okay, the four is irrelevant to me. But so I am sticking with Dennis Rodman for my section for Thingamajig.
Okay.
The only thing that threw me off is whoever Thingamajig has a awesome.
Oh
voice.
My God, he was awesome.
Oh my God, like both our jaws dropped when he was singing.
Yeah,
like,
so that really threw me off.
Yeah.
So I don't know. So that's going to be, I can't wait for that one. So probably he'll be one to go to the end. He had to wait the whole season to figure it out. Yeah. So the next one was The Skeleton. I put No Fear, Far From Dead, Second Fiddle, Spotlight. It was ready for the spotlight to be on himself.
Yeah.
Christmas Party, and then Older Guy. I have no guess for The Skeleton, guys.
Not one.
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, I was thinking about what he said about Martin Short, so I was playing that in my head. Mm-hmm. I just don't think Martin Short would be moving like that still. Like, I feel like I've seen him in things recently, mm-hmm. or at least within the last few years, and he still was able to kind of move around and jump around like the goofy person he usually plays. So, I don't know. I wasn't getting Martin Short from that. I know that was kind of the main one that everyone was saying. So, and then, when he did start singing at the end for the battle round, I got kind of soulful, like maybe he is a black guy.
Yeah.
God, that's,
here we go.
I gotta stop saying that.
So same thing, Robin. I have no clue. Same clues that I kind of jotted down for him. She has. I did think that he's very old, just because the way he was moving. I know at one point he had to get help coming downstairs. He does not move very fast. And I did get so far. I was like, okay, this has got to be a black old person. And then the songs that he picked were Good Times with Cheek, and then the Sugar Hill Gang. I'm sorry. So I said, those are really odd choices for someone,
you know what I'm saying? Younger. So
a younger person.
I'm so very curious. Curious. So if y'all saw it, who did y'all think that was? Because I have no idea.
Yes.
The next one was Ladybug. I put TV show.
I do like her.
TV show, Lifetime of Drama, Born into the Limelight, Famous Family. And then there kept being pictures of dogs in mail, like mail in the dog's mouth.
Yeah.
So I put that. And I cannot think, guys, because there was one point I was going to write down that I thought maybe it was Kelly Osbourne. I thought it was her, and I thought maybe she was, you know, talking in a different voice to hide the accent. So I did think Kelly Osbourne. And I also wrote down, Aliana. Is that Aliana? I think that's her name. Lohan, which is Lindsay Lohan's sister. The only thing with that is that they are from New York. But they, I don't feel like they have New York accents. Like, I even sometimes think Lindsay Lohan is kind of a... She doesn't have that accent like she's from New York.
Yeah.
So I wrote down Lindsay Lohan's little sister is what I wrote down. But this person kind of really seemed like they had a country type of twang to them.
Yeah. So same clues with the Ladybug. I also did add that they kept showing a bridge, but I don't know if it was the Brooklyn, it was some type of bridge. And then the dog they did show was a poodle. They showed two different pictures. It was always like a poodle type dog with the mail in the mouth, and then it had like a bat. And the Ladybug been through something. That, I mean, even by her speaking, she's really been through something. So I first wrote down, because of the whole TV and the judge and this and that, I wrote down Judge Judy. But then when she sung her battle song, I took that out, because, okay, because whoever there was, definitely the country start coming out more. So even though these are not country singers, I wrote down Cyndi Lauper and Pat Benatar because of the raspiness of their voice.
So you think it's someone older?
I think it's someone older. Oh, it's definitely someone older.
You think so?
Yeah.
Because I first thought older, but when they started to sing, I was like, oh no, it's somebody younger.
Yeah. I mean, so. And even so, the singer, I mean, they're the raspiness of the voice, and I think, okay, what to... And Cyndi Lauper came up first, and then Pat Benatar came up second. So those are my two choices for Ladybug.
Okay. So the next one was the Rottweiler. I wrote football, someone who likes to look good, so looking good. Mm-hmm. They became famous overnight, or very quickly. Mm-hmm. And they are looking to show the doubters that it's not over. And they've got bit by a dog.
Yeah.
So that was another one for me that I was very confused on. I really didn't have a lot of options, but as they got out there and were performing and a little bit of the voice, I thought maybe it was AJ from Backstreet Boys. And I think maybe they just want he the whole show people it's not over because you know people think oh they're you know they're old and you know they've had like a couple of hits here and there but not nothing that's really put them back out there to be like the number one type of deal. So I thought maybe it's AJ from Backstreet Boys.
So same clues. The clues are very basic with the Rottweiler. The dog that they said it did get by was a Rottweiler, so that's why he said he picked that. In singing, I was like, okay, I got the boy band reference to me. So I chose Lance Bass. I had it in my head at first. Then when they had asked him a question, he said something about, oh God, he said, I forgot the word he used. What word he used? I said, okay, this is definitely Lance Bass from NSYNC. So that's who I'm going with.
Okay. The next one was The Tree.
The tree has sass.
Season is over. So basically they said that they're seasonal type of deal. They've been away for a very long time. More than an expert in delicious treats. And first live performance. So totally, once again, another one very confused. So I started thinking of some of like the Food Network stars that I can remember. I did feel like it may have been a black lady. I felt like so I started thinking of some. There were a couple of them I did not know the name of, so I did Google some of the stars on the show, and it was a cooking contest. America, like worst cooks in America type of contest.
Okay.
And I don't know why I was watching it because I really don't watch those shows. And there was a woman named Lorraine Pascal.
Okay.
And I said, maybe it's her. Okay. But I remember the woman, she was really lively. She is from overseas. So maybe it's another thing of trying to maybe throw off people. But I'm kind of going with her right now.
Okay. So same clues. I went on to Food Network star. Like I said, the whole thing being a seasonal person. They put emphasis on her like getting put in the storage bin so it's time again. Mm-hmm. And then the cooking aspect was honed in on sweets because it said sugar and stuff like that. And it had mixing bowls. So I picked, because I went to, I said, okay, what Food Network star? I know it's not Rachel Ray because Rachel Ray doesn't do a lot of sweet stuff. The only one I could think of, at first I was going to do Paul Dean. I was like, well, no. And then I was going to do another lady. I forgot her name, so I didn't put her. But I did put Giada De Laurentiis, which is a Food Network star. I don't know if her show's still on Food Network. She has some controversy with her and another Food Network star. But
see, that could be it, though, the exile.
Yeah, because she was accused of sleeping with another star, and that was the demise of that star's marriage. Could be.
Yeah. The last one was Ice Cream, and I wrote Every Day is a Cheat Day.
Spoiler.
Oh, yeah. Spoiler. This was another one that ended up getting sent home.
Yes.
Ridiculous dream turned successful. Mm-hmm. Rich, billion, karate and fighting behind a different mask. Performs in front of millions. I did not know a name. I just knew it was some type of YouTuber.
That's just what good I... you stuck to that.
Yeah, I stuck to it. I said, it's a YouTuber. It's definitely a YouTuber.
I didn't go to YouTuber. So, same clues as well. So it's going to turn billions or something like that. So I was like, okay, billionaire. That's an easy list to eliminate. But I couldn't think it. So I did stick to billionaire and I was like, okay, it's a young person. Tall, had very big feet.
Yeah.
So I went to Mark Zuckerberg at first. And then I changed. Well, it's the two I had was Mark Zuckerberg from Facebook, of course. And then Buckethead, which is a famous guitar player that wears a bucket on his head. No one that I know has ever seen this man's face. But he's really a humble person.
Yeah.
And he does a lot of live shows. And doesn't too much care to be. Oh, you know what? Now that I said that, he doesn't too much care to be in the spotlight. Like, he turned out a $1 billion deal from Sony.
Mm-hmm.
So, but that's why I did Buckethead, the guitar player. And it ended up being
Tyler, or better known as Ninja.
Ninja.
So, I knew that he streamed.
I would never guess that.
I don't know how her kids look at it, or at least her son looks at it.
Yeah,
that's how I knew who he was. So yeah, it was him. So kind of more of a Twitcher gamer. But he does do YouTube stuff too. So I feel like I kind of was right on that one.
Yeah, because it's cool. But now thinking about it, you know, because they say he's like also like a big Minecraft, Minecraft player too. I heard of him because my son actually wanted me to watch a video of his.
Yeah.
He was like, watch the Ninja video. And I was like, okay, I'm not watching the Ninja video.
But he sounded really good.
Yes,
guys.
He sung.
He did a really good job.
When he sang Lil Durk's.
No, he did not. He sung Lil Nas X. Old Town Road.
Dang, Old Town Road.
But he did a really good job.
He
so, anyways, you guys let us know what you think, what you thought, if we were off, if we missed some things, and we will definitely be back next week to update and see if we were right and if we were wrong, okay?
All right. So, like, subscribe, share, comment, and hit the notification button for the next video. Mwah.